According to research that was conducted by Uganda Child Rights Non-Government Organization Network in the year 2022 and 2023, it was observed that 6 out of 10 children are currently in child labor and many mostly in stone quarries, landing sites, factories, among others. During their engagement meeting that was organized by African Network for the Prevention and Protection Against Child Abuse and Neglect, Uganda chapter in partnership with Global March Against Child Labor in Intinda to lay strategies on how to end child labor, the Executive Director, Global March Against Child Labor, Marco De Belt, said that Africa is still facing a huge challenge when it comes to child labor. Marco asked African leaders to urgently address all the issues contributing to child labor, such as poverty, school dropout, among others.
Is to create an area-based approach. In Uganda, it's known for under the child labor free zones. Those have been proven to be effective. They look at all the root causes of child labor: lack of education, lack of income, lack of awareness. All those things come together, and governments and regional leaders, but also international leaders, need to promote the area-based approach.
He also asked the sector players to come together to ensure that they sensitize communities against child labor.
We want to work with. This idea of the Global March has always been that if you want to eradicate child labor, you need to do that together. You cannot do that in a standalone basis. So CSOs need to be able to work with the government. They need to be working with the private sector. They need to be working with the trade unions and other important stakeholders.
Meanwhile, the Executive Director for African Network for Prevention Against Child Labor and Neglect Uganda, Eli Ignatius Nooha, asked government to address the issue of growing numbers of absent students during UNEB exams, since it has greatly contributed to child labor. Nooha asked all parents to try their level best to ensure that their children keep in school, since child labor will affect the country in the future.
Now we have a lemiso kuja what day in jala nibagamba katugende tufune ichituna kula tweyambe nokuyamba bazali bafe. So abana bano bali mu child labor munaku zinezi tuwadde bwani twali twebuuza nti tukwataganira wamutu tia fenge ebibiina binachewa mu Uganda ebiri wansi w'ekibiina kya Uganda kya Rice NGO Network tusale fena amagezi tulabe nti
at the same time, Caroline Bankusha, one of the researchers from the Uganda Child Rights Non-Government Organization Network, said that the fight against child labor is a joint effort. She asked parents to protect their children against child labor.
For this thematic working group, we are very, very grateful for always ensuring that we actually sit and discuss things pertaining to our children, things pertaining to the children of this country, things pertaining to the projects that we are handling in our various organizations. We are very, very grateful.
The government of Uganda defines child labor as children aged 15 to 11 years engaged in any economic activity, children between the age of 12 to 13 years doing work other than light work beyond 14 hours a week, or children 14 to 17 years involved in hazardous forms of labor or working for an equivalent of 4 to 3 hours or more in 2 weeks. Story compiled by Ismail Subuga for the news.